1997, Ghalib's 2 years centenary of birth, everybody was doing something, writing papers or issuing special issues or something. So I thought I should also do something in Finch of Hoon for him. I began collecting papers and commissioning papers. At the end of a two-year quest, I found that the best thing that I had got was a paper in Hindi by a young writer who was a PhD scholar. I said, I should write something. But then, what to write? Well, I have been writing so much about Ghalib, and other people have been also writing so much. Where is the space now to? So I thought, I'll write a story about him.
That's when you decided.
So I wrote a story in first person using a pseudonym, Beni Madhu Ruswa, a young Rajput of Azamgarh, where you and I come from, in the 1840s or so. How he gets to know Ghalib and how he gets to love him, what kind of influences are there for him, and how 1857 happens and his father sends him away. Anyway, so then when he talks to Ghalib, ultimately when they meet, I try to quote as much as possible from Ghalib's own letters about his life and conditions. And smuggle through my own notions about Ghalib and my own notions about where Ghalib went wrong also in Persian and so forth. So it again immediately it got the attention of people everywhere, and people began to ask, who is this Beni Madhu Ruswa? Where does he come from? And I have never heard of him. Then I realized that I still have that little spark of fiction in me, and my young youthful ambition of writing a huge big novel like War and Peace. Well, it's still doable somehow. So I wrote more stories over the same time, the same period. Mir, for example, Delhi, 18th century, Musafi, 18th, 19th century, and so forth. Then they all became successful. So somebody said, then this Dagh is a very colorful character, and you admire Dagh so much, you have called him a poet's poet, contrary to other people who said that he was a third rater and who only was sung by tawaifs and courtesans. So why not write about him? But when I went into it a little deeper, I found that this woman, who was his mother, was absolutely stunning.
You discovered her right at the beginning.
I knew about her, of course. The same story, she was a courtesan, she was a badmash aurat, she ran away with an English man. But she did give birth to a poet like Dagh. So the usual stereotypes about her that I knew. But when I went into the thing in more detail, her life, her times, Dagh himself, how he grew up under a shadow and so forth. I said, my God, here is a woman who is a rarity even today in the 21st century. So I said, okay, I write about her. But as
you
I
knew that you were going to do a novel in that stage?
Yes, because she was too big for a story. And another thing is that you might recall in my story on Mir, which is about 100 pages long, the first 30 pages I devote to things that didn't concern me at all. She begins from Bosnia or somewhere,
right.
Then she goes to Azerbaijan and so forth.
That's right.
Because the person with whom I have shown me falling in love should have depth, should have a certain background and history of it. She is just not one of those young people you see who come on the stage and dance and sing and go away. So she has to have something more to it. And where does the charisma come from? It has to come from partly from herself and partly from the past that she has over the 20 generations. I did the same thing here, that this woman should be given a past, should be given a background, a depth, a focus from where you can see each and everything in clarity.
It was first serialized, the novel.
No, not serialized, really. Not those chapters, the other chapters which are mostly about literature and poetry and literary culture. Two or three of them I published in Shakun and also in some magazines in Pakistan, just by way of testing the waters, in fact. Well, I'd been writing it for the last for 2 or 3 years by that time. And one good thing happened as a result of this advanced publication. A friend of mine who's no more among with us, Sirajuddin, professor of English at Osmania, whom Siva might know. So he wrote me a letter saying, "Hey, you're writing a great thing, but where are you going? What do you want to do with this huge packet of events and stories and cultures and characters?" Then I said, "Salam," I thought about it. Then I realized that actually, without quite knowing at all about it, I was creating in her a paradigm for Delhi. Mm. But Delhi had everything going for it. Culture, brilliance, knowledge, science, philosophy, everything. But she was on the backslide. Mm. Not at all, you see, able to stand. The same thing with this girl. Mm. She had everything for her, but she could never attain anything at all that she wanted to. Mm. Something stopped her. Something stopped other people who wanted her. Mm. They died or whatever happened to them.
So, but you knew when you were writing that it was going to be an epic kind of a length and...
Lengthwise, of course, epic, it's too big a word for it, but certainly I knew that it was going to be long. Mm. And when some people asked me later in Pakistan, why did you stop at 1856 and let her go out of the fort and then you stop there? I said, because I couldn't make it longer. It needed another kind of novel. Mm. When her short, say what, 4 or 6 months in Delhi after her being turned out from the fort, then going to Rampur and living there in obscurity, but bringing up her son and so forth. So a different kind of a story was needed for that. Mm. This momentum, this particular wave, you see, of events and things had to stop here.
Mm. So you've been one of those most renowned editors and critics. You have done a pathbreaking study on Mir in 4 volumes, an exhaustive and an innovative study. You've revived Dastans and the study of Dastans and Dastan Goi. You've been a poet, you've written short stories, and now you've written this wonderful novel. Is there anything that you still feel you want to do? Any genre that you want to attempt?
Of course, my work with the Dastan is yet unfinished. As you know, 4 volumes have been printed of my study, and the 5th one now I'm writing. And I don't know that I live that long. It will be at least 12 or 14 volumes. But my other ambition is to write one more novel.
Wonderful.
And my minor small footnote ambition is to translate my stories into English and give them to Shiva.
That's wonderful. That's excellent. Lovely. So maybe we can do this interview again next year or next year.
Hopefully. If I am around.
And the novel, any idea about that, or is just a desire at this stage?
Shiva has brought out 30 or 40 copies of the uncorrected proof for people to read and give their opinion on. So I suppose you also can read it if you like in that form. So I don't want to say anything. I've already said too much. I don't want to say. Please, thank you very much.
Lovely. Thank you very much.